So what is a file system, which are the most important characteristics, and which are the most popular out of them? Let's get started! Hello everyone, really nice to meet you. I'm Michael with Recoverit, and this is the YouTube channel of one of the most popular and effective data recovery solutions. What we usually do is to present you easy to follow and easy to implement practical data recovery solutions. Today's episode is going to be a bit different because we are going to talk about one of these things that many people don't really understand well, but we're somehow engaged each and every moment when we are accessing some kind of data, namely, that's the file system structure, definition, and features. Most likely you've heard the term file systems, but you're sort of unaware of how exactly they work, which are their most important characteristics, and generally how to troubleshoot them. And the more we know, the greater the chances are that we might recover some accidentally deleted or damaged files. So let's not waste any further time, get subscribed to the channel, and let's get started with the topic. Now, coming from definition perspective, a file system, and maybe to put it into simple words, it is a method that a computing system is using in order to manage, store, and access files. The file system handles everything, right from naming the file to deciding its logical data structure. It's also responsible for retrieving the data from a particular file. Basically, the file systems allow us to control the data which is stored on our drives or whatever the storage we use. Could be a hard disk drive, an SSD, flash storage, micro SD card, and many, many others. In most cases, the file system allows us to manipulate these files in the way we want, as long as it is supported by the file system, like copying, moving, renaming, deleting, etc., etc. So, in short, yeah, this would be the part of the operating system which is allowing us to handle and manage the files which are stored on the drives. This leads us to the next important characteristic, and that would be the type of the file system. It's a fact that most different operating systems support different variety of file systems. And it could be that, for instance, if you use an Apple device and they have their own proprietary Apple file system, it wouldn't be accessible or readable on a Windows workstation. So how all of that really works? Well, you could consider the file system as an index for all the data which is stored on a storage device. The file system specifies the naming structure and the rules to name different files. Some file structures are case-sensitive in nature, which means that you can't use uppercase characters to the file name. The file system also defines the character length of a file. While naming the files, you can't go beyond the specified character limit, otherwise the file system automatically triggers an error message. Apart from the basic information, the file system also holds advanced details such as the size of the file, its attributes, and its target location. All these details are stored in the metadata, which is a separate block on the storage device that your system uses to fetch data from the file. This metadata also stores a directory error key to pinpoint the exact location of a particular file on the storage device. Now, coming to the types of the file systems, and as we mentioned a bit earlier, certain operating systems have access to certain file system types. Some OSs could support a wider variety of file systems, some not really. I guess we're going to start with the most popular one, and that's related to the Microsoft Windows operating system. It's called FAT, so popular FAT file system. It's probably one of the oldest file systems which are supported by multiple operating systems, including Windows. FAT stands for File Allocation Table. In many situations, a file is broken down into multiple sections that are scattered across the hard drive of a system. The FAT file system is responsible for keeping a track of these sections to make it easier for the system to fetch the data when requested. Ideally, the FAT file system supports up to 8 characters, and the name should always begin with an alphanumeric character. Okay, going further with FAT32 or FAT32, it's the advanced version of the original FAT file system. So it's an improvement, and it's mostly targeted at customers running Windows 2000 and older, meaning that you can still find it well supported with some computers that are being utilizing a newer and fresher versions of Windows. It's very suitable for devices coming from a size of 512 megabytes up to 2 terabytes, and they do support a much greater amount of files to be stored. FAT32 makes disk utilization more effective, as it can access files more rapidly across different storage devices. Continuing with NTFS, and I remember it's something that was presented for the first time with Windows XP. And there was the way to upgrade and actually convert the file system from FAT32 to NTFS, but going backwards was a no-go. Anyhow, so with NTFS everything is a lot more advanced, and the file system is no longer case-sensitive, meaning that as a user you have the liberty to name the files the way you want. Next, APFS. That's the Apple file system. It's something that the company has developed back in 2016 in order to strengthen its position and to also improve the performance on its various devices. But the thing is, it's only supported on iDevices, on MacBooks, iPhone, iPod, etc. Thing is, it's if you format a flash drive into APFS, it's only going to be accessible by operating systems which are capable of reading APFS, so understand iOS or macOS. Therefore, in order to read and write data to the very same flash drive and this to be accessible by another operating system, you have to reformat the drive into NTFS or FAT32. Kind of awkward. Since we talk about Apple, here's something else you might come across. HFS Plus. Yet another invention and development by the Cupertino-based company, something they presented back in 1998. It was considered a revolution as it replaced the conventional hierarchical file system used by Apple computers. HFS Plus enhanced the performance and made file accessibility more rapid. Even in 1998, HFS Plus supported up to 255-character limit. So this concludes our journey across the most popular file systems. Of course, there are a lot more, and we've tried to narrow down the most popular ones, I guess. You might look around for more information about ext3 and 4, which are popular Linux-related file systems. The best news for you is that our award-winning solution, Recoverit, is capable of recovering damaged or accidentally deleted files from most of the popular file systems. And in the comments below, you can let us know which are your favorite file systems and why. If you find this video insightful, then please make sure to subscribe to our channel. I'm Michael. Look forward to seeing you in our next practical data solution tutorial. Bye!